Right. Yeah, Beta had to actually be standing almost next to me to get me in the guild. So, Justin, what are you looking for in this game? I mean...
I don't know.
Yes, the boot physics are nice, Cryptor. Well, I mean, are you looking for just a certain aspect of the game? Like, are you more of a crafter? Are you more of an explorer? Are you just, you know...
Everything but PvP.
There you go. Right. This game is really confusing to me. It much just like Arch 8 was for like the first like almost month, dude. It took me, I mean, you know, I got into crafting right off the bat, and you know, because I knew in Arch 8 if you didn't grab a couple pieces of land right off the bat, you know, you're in SOL. But I really like the knowledge in this though, because that way, I mean, I have the option now to talk to every single body, do, you know, and my freaking hawk is just freaking amazing, Cryptor. You got one too. You had the same account type that I have, which if you go to your account page and you claim all the stuff except for your 7-day passes, you can go to your inventory and to your pearl tag, and you'll have like your 5 pieces of furniture. You'll get your horse flute, you'll get your partial combat reset, your appearance chains, and you get your 5 stuff. Which you get a tier 3 horse, and you get a little pet, which he will go loot stuff for you every so often. He will go find rare monsters for you. I picked the hawk. He just kind of floats above me, and he lands on my shoulder like a falconeer. Pretty sweet. And the cool thing about this Cryptor, I like about these graphics too, is like when it lands on my shoulder, it's literally on my shoulder, not like, you know, hovering above it. He actually, you can see him put his claws towards into my shoulder. Justin.
I'm on Kinley right now. I think I'm in a tutorial. This is the first time I've logged in.
Oh, yeah, yeah. This freaking bird is like picking up everything of mine. Sweet. Go to your account. You know the web page.
Sorry, I forgot to turn the stream on. Had the placeholder thing there for a while.
And then you'll just accept everything, and it could take up to 24 hours for everything to be mailed to you.
Is there a chat box?
Kind of, sorta.
Yes. Well, you might have it disabled. I know I had a whole bunch of problems where all my UI elements were disabled, and I didn't see the mini map or anything. And Basil here told me how to turn that stuff on.
Just hit your escape bar or escape button and go to UI enhancement, or yeah, and then you're able to let you turn on stuff, turn stuff off.
Okay. I'm in my account. It says I have guest pass 7 days available, housing decor package, pet package, and general item package. So pet.
Yep.
I can click on the pet.
Should I click on all of it except the 7 day? Well, you can click on the 7 day pass, but I don't know how long after you click it, how long you've got to give it out.
Wow, oh, that's nice. There's like 4 times 12 pets to choose from.
Mm-hmm. Which, for some reason, when I looked at it, I thought the hawk was an owl, because I will be playing a wizard soon. So I was like, ooh, you know, an owl would be pretty cool for a wizard, you know. Mm-hmm. And I named him Wisdom. But everything, the horse and the pet is count bound, so... when you log into your characters, they're there. All of them have it.
Okay, got the pet. General items, what is that? Is that stuff I can wear?
None of it's stuff you can wear. There's like 5 mystery boxes of dyes. There's like 5 steel. There's like 5 steel.
We get a horse.
Yeah, a tier 3 horse at that. What do you call gathering stuff? You get 5 steel gathering tools.
That is fantastic.
But I haven't figured out where the dang dyes are at yet. I haven't found the dyes. Oh, they're in my inventory. I know dye boxes, like 5 of them, I think. Or 5 different ones you can get. Yeah, there's 5 of them. But I don't want to dye anything yet, because I don't know how the dye system works. If it's like Guild Wars and them, where it's applied to the whole account, or, you know, just discard.
No. I'm having an issue with mine that for some reason it doesn't show me when I equip new equipment on my character. It doesn't show, and it doesn't show the customization I did on my character. Like other people, like KJ met me in game, he can see my character as I made it with like the tattoos and stuff, but when I look at it, it's just, there's no customization at all. It's just the generic
under equipment. You know how you got the outer circle, which sets your equipment, and then the inner circle is like your costume.
What is that under?
Inventory.
Okay.
And then, like I said, the outer one is actually your gear. The inner is your outfit. So, I don't know if you turn stuff on or off. How that changed. Because I don't get it neither. Because like my character technically has red hair, but for me, she's got black hair.
Well, I looked at the forums, and there is a little guide somebody wrote in there, and it essentially says that servers don't save the looks properly, but what you can do is you can change the instance of the server, like from the Media 01 to something else. You have to stay in that new one for 15 minutes, because that's the rule, and then you can go back to this one. Oh, hey, And when you come...
See, I see you. You've got, like, some face paint on.
See, I don't see any of that.
Your hair's in two braids in the front?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what do you see on me?
Just red, long red hair.
See, mine's black on my side.
So basically the guide said if you switch those instances, then the server is forced to resave like the cache or whatever of what your character looks like, and then it resets it to what it should be.
So I'm gonna try that. How do you trade? Change shift, okay. Let's go to 02. Let's see if that changes me and you for standing in front of each other.
Well, you won't be able to see me until you come back.
Well, not when you take off from me.
No, but if when yeah, you disappeared already.
Oh, okay.
When you change instance, you go away from here. We should.
What? I still got black hair. I still have black. I look identical.
Did you want? I don't know which hair are you supposed to have.
Well, when you go to my character, my selection screen, she's got red hair, bright red hair, like what you see.
Okay, so
what I see is she's wearing coal black hair.
Okay, so according to that guide, if you can move that character to another instance on the server for 15 minutes and then go back, it should reset it and then it should look how it's supposed to.
Okay.
I never personally tried it, but...
You know what, I didn't realize the time. I'm actually going to have to head off. I will probably be back tomorrow to get through this intro stuff.
Okay.
No problem, dude. We'll be here.
Okay, I'll talk to you later.
Cheers. Man, I know nothing whatsoever about 80% of stuff in this game, but I like it.
I know, that's the way I am too. I have no fucking clue what I'm doing. Literally! I'm smashing buttons to kill stuff, which, that's cool, you know, that's fine, but I mean, you know what I'm saying, it's really weird.
Man, there's fucking... I wanna be a beekeeper. I actually found a bee farm. You can apparently be a beekeeper. I have no clue how I get there, but someday...
Crypto says someday I will be there,
some fucking day I'm gonna have a bee of my own. Fuck, I really like it that, like, every profession in this game is like a mini game of its own. Nothing is just like point and click. I haven't tried fishing yet. A lot of people seem to like it.
I hear it's really easy to AFK though. Like, you just throw it in and AFK, you know. Which I'm okay with that. I mean, shit, it works, you know, but...
Hell yeah. I don't know. I haven't tried it. Okay, but oh man, I am so fucking happy that we have a horse. Those things are fucking expensive.
Yes, they are.
And my donkey just makes me look silly.
That's the way they were in Arcade 2.
Okay.
Yeah, they're kept really small for some reason, and you know. I mean, I don't mind grinding. I mean, you know, as well as I do, it's a Korean game, so there's options that's going to be grind somewhere. And I'm, like I said, I'm happy that as long as I have people to play with, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly. That's the key. That's the key right there. Spar. Don't say that it does. Is there a market?
And now I understand why the barbarians are so tall, because they're giants.
Oh yeah, that's true. I have to go to market to pick this shit up, but it looks like I made about 20,000 just by selling stuff I gather.
Nice.
Crap, I just killed one here.
I'm gonna do some reading on some crafting and stuff like that too, because there's a lot of crafting stuff that's really nice in this game.
Mm-hmm. Big guys though. Stuff here. Oh, we're done.
How's it going?
Hey, man.
Good, 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 good. So Beta, I'm glad you're on.
Oh.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing at this point?
That's good. Well, alright. Here's my deal. I'm in the town of... Well, I should say the closest town is... Hydale, which I'm sure you're there, you're level 15, so I know you're around this area, right?
I'm actually way over leveled for where I'm at. I haven't gotten to the next city yet.
So you're still in Villa then, right?
Yeah, because I'm doing way too many mini quests everywhere.
Well, that's good. Well, it doesn't matter. It was just easier if you were here to maybe explain, but... Okay. The purpose of connecting your nodes, okay, is faster reproduction, not reproduction, but faster production, right?
Well, for the thing, there's nodes that have the resources on it, and you connect the node to the city that you're having the production in. So the node has to connect to the city that you have the workhouse and the workers in to be able to have the workers get the product, bring it to the place, and then process it.
Follow-up question. Do you need to have a house in that city then?
Yeah, you need it. Well, you don't have to have a house per se, but there are workshops and other stuff and for the different places. I haven't actually started up my production stuff yet, because It actually looks really complicated.
Well, I like complicated crafting. I really do. But what I'm trying to say is that your what fucking points are those? Your contribution points.
Yeah, you. I have the contribution 13. Points. You connect the nodes with that.
Right, but let's say if I use 10 of them with connecting nodes, and those stay connected for how long? Until I unconnect them, right?
Yeah, forever until you decide to get your points back.
So, since I have 13, and let's say I use 13 of them doing nodes, let's say. Now, will I always collect contribution points as I go? Or, I mean, like, since I've got 13 out, and let's say I get 14, or I get one more, it gives me 14, that means I have one open and 13 out, right?
Okay, getting contribution points, when you do quests, you'll see, oh, what do you get when you finish the quest? And the thing that's a gold medal with a green ribbon off of it, that's actually experience points for your contribution. And you build
right.
It, like, it's like an experience point thing to build it up. So yeah, you will end up getting them as long as you keep questing.
Right, I know, that's what I'm saying. But let's say I have, say, 14, or 1 out of 14. Okay, because obviously 13 of them are out doing notes. And if a house says I need to have 5, that means I have to go and get 5 more, which will put me at, what, 19? I'd have to have altogether 19. Because 13 of them are out doing something else.
Yeah, I mean, that's one of the reasons why I'm overdoing questing here, because right now I have 24.
Okay. Well, that's what I'm trying to find out, because I know that your maximum you can have is 300 contribution points. So I'm trying to figure out to manage my points as I go. Should I wait to get a house per se until I reach pretty high up there? And use the rest of it for, like, nodes, crafting, and stuff like that.
From what I understand, as you level, the best way to use it is whatever city that you're centered around with your questing is to buy a house or your workshop in that city, whatever you happen your next, your goal is. Either you want to set up workshop and have workers mining stuff around that city so that you can just pull all your nodes up, all the places that you have quested already, and into the local region and just do everything in that area. Because once you get 300, then you can spread out a lot, but as you're going along with, just a few points, you're gonna have to be limited to, maybe a worker at mining some copper and ore, and then a couple of workers actually producing something.
I'm the head of the League of Merchants, Grace Lauren. Nice to meet you. The Valley Ring. They say it suits a tired country. I'll never let this indicate.
Like, the idea is not just to slap them down wherever you want, unless you're doing a lot of mob grinding. In which case, having it on there helps a little bit. And then, unless you want to add the work points to it also. But yeah, most of it's just whatever you happen to want to do for your local region. Until you can get enough points to actually set up a full length trade routes and other stuff to where you want to pull resources from in every direction.
Okay, this chick wants me to do some. She's a node resource.
Okay, so I have one worker. I'm going to try to get something happening here. I have one worker in this city. Ah, fuck. Should I buy a house? Watch out, these things.
Just for the record, AFK fishing, early today was really great. That was 200,000, and just because I AFK did it for a couple hours.
Really? Wow.
So I've invested 1 point in this wheat garden. Now I can go back to that town. Actually, I can go to this node up here and connect that one.
Yeah, remember the node has to connect back to the town or the city that has your worker in it.
Right. I don't have a worker yet.
I got one from a quest. I should probably buy a house first and then do this stuff, otherwise it could get screwed up.
And see, this is the housing that I wish Archage had, because it's a little different. Archage is just crazy.
Yeah, I much prefer the instance housing.
Yeah, always. Well, I can't say that, because I'll tell you, the best housing that I've ever seen was in Star Wars Galaxies.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you Encryptor, you and you said that was brilliant the way they done that.
It was, until people started leaving, and then it was a nightmare.
Well, they left out the mayor's ability to get rid of a house if it's been unoccupied for X amount of days. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because that's what I thought was stupid. I'm like, why would you... I mean, you take somebody in your guild and, you know, of course you would say, hey, if you know you're going to be gone for, like, you know, a month or two, please deconstruct your house. When you come back, I'll try to put you in the same spot, or I'll put, you know, somewhere in town. But they didn't. They just disappeared and said, fuck you.
So I bought a refinery place, and there was three options: storage, refinery, and something else. I don't even know how to enter it now. That fucking black ghost thing is starting to creep me out a bit.
It's like he's everywhere. He's everywhere. He's kind of like a stalker.
I really find him useful just because he has like the tutorial stuff and all the information in the guide section.
That's true. We should do that.
Like, I was looking up stuff a moment ago, and my gathering had reached level 10 beginner, and it told me, hey, you should go talk to this person.
Nice.
Like, it keeps bringing relevant information to me, so I think that it's really cool. It has to have some way of actually knowing that some of the stuff that I was doing, like the fishing stuff, it brought that information up for me.
That's awesome.
Not when I first started fishing, but the second time I started fishing, I think it, when I was looking for information again, yeah, it was available from there too.
This is a legal business permitted by the head of the League of Merchants. You can trust me.
I just wish they would expand it a little bit more, because while it's useful, there's so much information that you need to know about this game.
When I start getting one to play, I can't play because I gotta go to fucking bed.
I'll protect them all.
Welcome to the Valley Lily Inn. How does Serendia look to your eyes?
Calphian scum, unbelievable. Lee, what did that jackass just say?
Did you hear a cat speaking somewhere?
You rat. How dare you?
Hunt, lower your voice. We have guests. Tell them to come again later.
We'll be here every day until you repay Bobby Lauren's debt. You heard the lady. Get lost.
Hunt, is it? Listen up. The Lady Isabel's patience has worn thin.
I'll be right back.
Serendian ever.
Yeah, and I'm back.
Alright. FK, just a minute, I'll be right back.
New challenge. don't think I have any.
Hello there, I'm Laura. No.
That I like too is when you go AFK, it kind of gives you like this moving, like screensaver.
Oh,
yeah, yeah, it goes into like cinematic mode.
Yeah. How do you invest?
What are you investing in?
Node management, but it won't let me put anything in this.
Are you in Hadal by any chance?
Try sprinting across an open field on the back of a horse. It feels so nice. I prefer Serendia to help you, no matter what they say. Feed your horse a carrot whenever it gets exhausted. Breeding sometimes results in an excellent steed.
Because when I go, here we go.
I can't find the NPC to invest with. The load management one, or the labor one.
Motherfucker wants 10. Got 10 contribution points and 32,000 coins.
What is that for?
Residence.
I don't even know how much I paid.
City and buying a house there. I need to connect these two nodes with that, then I gotta buy a worker.
contract with the Warbringer in the right place.
Hey, Basil.
Yes, sir.
How did you find the node management guy?
I haven't found the one in the main town yet.
For cities, there is no node management. They're automatically invested in stuff for every city. And then they're usually connected to one of the... They at least have two nodes outside of every city that the city's already connected to.
Really?
So you choose what node is in the direction that you want to be connecting stuff up to. The one that's directly connected to the city, and then you go from there.
Where's the worker guy?
Not sure if you can see it in that city, but they're depicted by a pickaxe on the map.
Oh, okay. Pickaxe?
Yep, I see him.
Sorry, what's depicted as a pickaxe?
The guy that you rent workers from.
Oh.
I was so happy to get, you know, a good decent amount of money for AFK fishing and stuff, and then I keep seeing that stuff pop up, like, oh, this stuff is on the thing for like 12 million, and so it makes that, you know, a couple hundred thousand look like nothing.
Yeah.
Oh shit, I have 20k. But I was pretty much just questing so far.
So he tells me to go talk to this guy, but I can't find him. It says how to hire Heisel worker. Managed by Joe. He's just a work supervisor in the city. Material vendor.
Welcome. around here is full of examples.
Cannot find him anywhere. What the hell? So what's storage look like?
I forgot where I bought it, but I bought a chest that you can put in your housing that acts as a banking NPC. How to put that in my house? I have no idea. I tried. Oh shit, my horse is almost dead. Take him to stable. And by horse I mean donkey.
This is aggravating me. Joe's not in this town.
Well, what's the name of
the I know
NPC?
Where Joe is.
Joe.
Hey, Doll City.
That's where I'm at.
Okay, he's right by the water. That's the worker labor guy, right?
Yeah, the guy you get the workers from.
Yeah, he won't give me any.
Why?
I don't know. I have one though. I got one from a quest, that's all I know. But when you go down to the river, he's on the left side, right by the bank, close to the banking guy.
Okay, I just changed back to server and I look the same.
So much for that idea. I'm guessing it's gonna take them a patch or two, you know, to iron out all these little things.
Yeah.
My donkey has 1 HP.
You gotta feed him carrots, you know that, right?
I'm sure I do. Okay, where do I get a fucking carrot? Oh, this guy has carrots.
There's a stable guy.
Serendia is full of excellent horses.
There's guild manager.
You're supposed to be by the river.
Tons of people fishing. And I mean a fuck ton.
Yeah. How do you feed it? Fuck. Give them all to rest, this? So the guild guy is on the right, then there's a bunch of people in the middle, then on the left there's a small house with the banking guy, and the jail guy is in front of it.
I don't see Joe nowhere.
Where are you standing right now?
Down the stairs. There's a soldier, there's the banking guy with a bunch of people in it.
Okay. Around the corner, the same building, that's where Joe is.
I'm stupid, I can't find it, no big deal.
I'm right there. He's right there, man. Did you go around the
corner?
Okay,
I see him. Yeah, the left side of the building. I went the right side.
Well, there's nobody on the right side.
Yeah.
No idea how to feed this fucking donkey. What if I do this? Nice, got it.
There's no more precious companion than a horse.
What's with all this stuff? Okay, let's find an NPC and... Can I train here?
I guess you're pretty good at sensing where the money is.
I'll be back in a few minutes. I need to grab some more coffee.
Okay.
I need a guy where I can sell stuff.
You look like you're in need of a lot of things. You best work hard or earn some more money.
So I can sell all this stuff. Let's screw that. Fuck. Okay, let's go to the market. What was the market NPC? Oh my god, have mercy. I am so fucking lost in the city. Holy shit.
This is a legal
market.
Committed by the head of the League of Merchants.
My registered items. Registered these guys. Max confirm. other nonsense I can sell. You know what? Let's just put on. What's this? Go away. Gonna run to the quest location. So, whatever, let's do these guys. Oh, going over the bridge. Hey Nerdy, do you know who is Grim Death? Somebody who requested a friend list thing, but he doesn't, or he or she doesn't reply.
I wouldn't accept it then.
Well, I gotta. I mean, that's the only way our guys can get guild invites. Try Shadow Raven. What is this? PM the wrong person or something, or to the wrong name? We'll see.
Were you attacked by scarecrows on your way here?
Oh, funny.
The wheat from this farm can feed an entire nation.
Captain Tito cares more about his own career than he does the pain of the peasants.
Understand, Al Rundi. He used to
just like you.
Woohoo! I'm to a $94 in my PayPal credit now.
Is that the Blizzard?
No, fuck no, I wish. Oh. No, that's the bill me later that PayPal bought out.
There are lots of peasants like us. They all need our help.
Oh, this is the Vile Tutu? Toto?
Oh, the Ledo.
There you go, got him into the clan. So right now there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of us in here.
You know, guys are stupid. Let me explain to you why. You know, doesn't matter if the girl's fat, doesn't matter if the girl's ugly, doesn't matter if she's fucking small-tittied. Why would you walk up to a woman that's breastfeeding an infant in public and say, that's disgusting? That's one boob you get to see out of the shirt. You didn't have to ask for it. It just popped out there.
It's a freebie.
Yeah.
That has to be the best argument for that I've ever heard.
I know, Bobby. I've watched, because I am very pro-natural about things like that. You know what I'm saying? I don't think it's disgusting. I think it's fucking awesome that nowadays women are not afraid to feed their child in public, you know what I'm saying? Because even if you go home and use a breast pump, you're still allowing that natural milk to touch plastic. You know what I'm saying? It's still being poured into a chemical made product. I think it's just, it's awesome. Like I said, there's two reasons why. One, I get to see a fucking boob, and two, it's beautiful. It really is. Just like I think pregnant women are just so gorgeous. I do. Now I'm showing a side of me you guys have probably never seen, but anyway, it don't matter.
It's okay. Now I know what to get you for Christmas. A breast pump and a calendar with pregnant women.
There you go.
No, I totally agree, though.
Those type of people, I just want to punch in the goddamn face and say, really, dude?
I don't know. I think people like that have problem with that, just like people who see deviants and shit and like issues with everything, are people that are probably having some issues themselves.
Right.
Because if you look at that, and you never would have, like, to me, normal person would look at a woman feeding baby, and like, I don't know, something sick doesn't just come to your mind right away. If somebody does that and has like disturbing thoughts, they should probably seek fucking medical attention.
Yeah.
Oh fuck, I just realized I sold all my health potions.
Now really? Wife of Eagle's co-founder accidentally shot and killed.
Accidentally, huh?
Yes. One second.
Yeah. This fucking spirit that keeps appearing just keeps on growing as you go. Something tells me he's gonna be our biggest problem later on.
Yeah, there's several hints that there's major issues with them actually being around. I mean, other than the fact that when you encountered him, you lost your memory and all your abilities, so, you know.
Yeah, and every so often you encounter an NPC that freaks out because there is like a dark spirit present or something.
I actually read all the lore that was in that cave, where the dark spirit gets more powerful.
If you help us, we'll offer you a nice reward. I don't know what Al Rundy was like before, but he cannot be considered a human being any longer.
The stuff here may not be sophisticated, but it looks pretty good to my eyes.
Hold on, I have 6 player people on my friends list, but there's only 5 in the guild. Somebody's missing. Oh yeah, there's another person, Kali Said. No idea who that is.
Doesn't sound familiar.
Yeah.
I saw on the website apparently 2 people joined.
Yes, yes. One is Jeffrey, was it? The guy that was here earlier? Jay something? And the other one is... Ron or something. That'd be probably that Holy Slayer guy. That's AFK right now.
Sitting here waiting for my energy to come back. It says I have 1 skill point to spend, but I have no skills to learn. Why is that?
Most skills cost 4 to 8 skill points, especially as you get higher levels.
I'd like to know when I'm going to get my goddamn pet. Okay, I have a worker. Son of a bitch, hold on.
Now do I use this here? Destination can be seen from far away. Is that supposed to be it? Oh my god, that's far. Forget that. Let's help these guys. When I see people say stuff in the chat and it's orange text, is that general chat? No.
Yeah, that's global general chat.
How do you talk in global general chat, do you know?
Pretty sure it's just press enter to do it. Channel. So when you press enter on the left side, it says general. If you click it, and it will give you the option of channel, whisper, guild.
Yeah, I don't like if I when I talk in that general, I don't see anything in my chat window.
I love my wife.
I know that the channel chat actually uses up energy to be able to chat in the channel.
Seriously, wow.
I'm pretty sure it's done that way to prevent spam and arguments. Because eventually they have to run out of energy if they're going to keep spouting BS, right?
Okay. I have a skilled worker. Okay. So, does he automatically go out and do stupid shit for me, or do I need to, like, send him somewhere, or...?
No, you manage him through the worker thing.
Right, that's what I'm saying. All I have is a thing that's called, remove, cancel. Then when I hover over him, it says, craftsmanship increased work speed by 0.2 when leveling up. That's it. Toss this. Work speed 45, movement 2.5. But so, I mean, how do I know he's going out picking up the wheat for me and stuff?
I have no idea. I know that's not the answer you wanted to hear, but I really don't know.
Dude, stories. I need residency. Not residency. What do I fucking need? I forgot. Is there an upkeep for your house? Like, you gotta pay so much? I know.
No. Like I said, I hadn't really gotten into that section of stuff. I'm just starting to go through some of the basics of it. Because in the town that I'm in, it has the essentially the tutorial quests, where it's telling me I buy a refinery house in the town that I'm in, and then it will tell me how to do everything from there.
I'm looking for a refinery house here. We got mushroom workshop, residency storage.
I think it depends on like what city you're in. As far as what's available to you. I might be wrong though.
Oh, here city we go. Should have refinery. I mean, that's a very basic one.
Conditions of purchase of crop workbench. This is I have to have. What's it? So how do I know what I bought? Damn it! What'd I do?
Wow, the interface for this is really kind of confusing and irritating. Because it's listing what my contribution points that I have available and the money that I have and...
This is not helping me at all.
We gotta watch some YouTube guides.
Well, like I said, it has the quest thing in Velia that literally goes through most of it, from what I can tell. So I'm going through that right now.
But I still don't understand the nodes. I mean, my nodes are connected to here. So does my guy go automatically go out and fucking work or what?
Stupid AVG.
Hey, what's up, Slum?
Hey, stupid.
They broke AVG.
What does that even mean? What's AVG?
Can't get the free virus edition, antivirus edition. Fucking took me forever to find it.
So then it's not broke.
Yeah, you go to the website, they won't give you the regular ones. They want to give you that fucking Zen crap. I'd go to the support forum. What the fuck you guys doing?
Ah, yes. Slam, slam, slam.
RoboCraft's giving away free premium for 3 days. And you type 3 in capital letters, 3 today.
How do you get into your residency?
You go to the location that you actually bought it at in the city.
Okay. I'm there.
should be able to just open up the door, I think. I don't know what the startup time, like the refinery has 5 minutes before it's actually available.
Oh, so how do you get to the second floor of your house? Do you have to go somewhere, climb somewhere?
You're on the bleeding edge of research here, Nardi.
I think so.
Yeah, I didn't even know there were places with two floors.
I don't even know how many floors the place I have has. I don't even know how to enter it. What's expired?
My candle.
I don't think you do. It's just, like the tools, they can't be repaired. You just have to get a new one. You're talking about the lantern, right?
Yeah. No, you can buy oil for your lantern.
Okay, so it's not a full replacement. Where do you get oil from?
I'm getting this lady from the... general goods vendor. So you might want to buy a couple to keep with you. How do you go to the second fucking floor? That's what's making me mad.
Al Rundy must be punished. If you help us, we'll offer you a nice reward.
This must be my house. Yes, yes, it is.
Okay, what did you figure out?
Well, on the second floor, you gotta kinda go around the building, and there'd be a small set of stairs that you gotta walk up.
Oh, shit.
How do I know what do I have? Cause I don't want to purchase this shit, man. I want shit to. Oh, here's the spy stuff.
Somewhere. If I just kill the supplies, why do I? Not?
you can actually open up freaking windows.
No way. Nice.
That's cool.
Nice, I like this house better.
Holy shit. But I can't steal somebody's horse.
Ha ha!
Planks, barracks, supplies.
Isn't houses supposed to be connected together? So, hey, Beta.
Yeah.
So, okay, if I bought a house, I want to buy this one for, not residency, but I want to do one for crops. That's wood.
Okay, bedtime.
Later. Cheers, Mr. Slummy.
Have a good night.
Thank you.
So I understand how to assign workers in the city for the refinery. What I want to try and figure out now is how to get them to mine the stuff for me. So I'm heading out to one of the nodes and invest in, and hopefully I'll be able to figure it out here soon. Because that's what you wanted. You wanted a worker to farm, right?
Yes.
Of course, I didn't think ahead, and so I didn't have another worker available.
So
I'm running all the way back to town to hire another worker, and then hopefully figure out how to get him mining. It looked like I had to go to the node manager and do it from there, but I'm gonna double check it as soon as I hire a worker. Because as soon as I was at the node manager and invested in the mining part of the node, it asked me to assign a worker, and it said I didn't have one available, so maybe I can actually do it from the map though.
So what happens to your stuff that's in your house if you forget to pick it up?
What do you mean if you forget to pick it up?
Well, I sold one of my houses that I had. I had stuff in it.
It should have went to the city warehouse.
Okay, where's the city warehouse at? That's what I gotta.
Yeah, you need to find the warehouse manager.
Warehouse manager, I'm looking. So I got me two houses now. I got me one for my crops, right? And then I've got one for, let me see. Okay, I'm getting to know this town pretty well. You wait. I'll end up fucking leaving this town, going somewhere else and being screwed.
Yeah, that's what I was saying, as you're leveling up, you're essentially destroying everything and then rebuilding it in the next hub city. Which is actually not too bad, because at least you can move all your stuff to the new location as you're going around, and then decide where you want your final stuff at the end. Okay, so it says I need lodging to hire more workers.
Yes.
Which means a house.
Yeah, yes. I purchased a residence, but that's apparently different than lodging.
Yes, and something I just found out. If you, you know, you open up the house management thing, it shows you all the houses in the town. If you go to lodging, you know, at the top it'll ask you, you know, it'll say crop stories, look for lodging. You need to buy a house, a residency house, to put with it, because you want all your houses linked together. Supposedly it makes things go a whole lot better.
Okay, so I purchased a residence, and then I think that's both lodging? Because the other two are, I guess, in other rooms of the house. Yeah, they're actually rooms of a house. So, two lodging rooms and one residence. So I have a storage, a refinery, a residence, and two lodging. This is getting a little crazy for the amount of points that I'm investing into this. I didn't realize it was going to be quite this much.
That's fun.
So if I want to refine both iron and copper, I need to. Okay, so I can. So this one is making the blackstone powder, and then I need something else to be able to refine the iron and copper and stuff. See, I still don't understand how to do the metal then.
get back in a minute.
Okay, I figured out how to do the thing. The mineral workbench is the one, and it's only available in a single residence here. So I have to change this thing from storage to mineral workbench to be able to actually have them refine the iron and stuff for me, so I can make essentially fishing poles and other things. I'm trying to figure out how to make pickaxes and stuff too.
Alright, so I'm building my lodging now, which I think I got enough to buy storage next. Now I need to start doing quest. What are you doing, Cryptor?
I'm just questing, man.
Yeah.
So I figured out how to do the minerals. I found the workbench for you.
Well, I suppose you're supposed to be able to put the workbench in your house, in that type of house.
Oh, well, I changed it over to a mineral workbench as the actual type of building.
Mm-hmm.
And I have no idea what that actually does. It's gonna take it like 20 minutes to actually turn it into a mineral workbench at this point.
That's what I've been fucking... Oh my god. I think that's where all my points went, because I was at 14, I'm at 2 now. And I've only bought 2 houses, so 6 points. I'm at 2. So I bet you I've used points to turn fucking houses into certain things that I'm not going to use.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Because each one of these was at least 1 contribution point for each individual building, no matter what it was.
How do you get those back?
By releasing a building. The same kind of way that you would with a node.
But it's showing, it's only showing that I have, like, 1 house. Oh, no shit, wait a minute, all white houses are mine, right?
Yep.
Oh,
I can see my worker on the map going to the node.
That's pretty cool.
Why can't I purchase this one? Let's see, what is this I need?
I'm confused. Can I not see what my own refinery looks like?
But it only shows one of my houses when I've got two houses now. How's that fucking work?
The other one might look gray unless you selected what to put in there, whether it's a residence or lodging or whatever.
I don't know. Rain, don't know what blue means.
Blue means that you own that house.
No, white does.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Yeah, I guess blue means that it's available. Let me actually take a look. Yeah, blue just means that you can buy it if you want to.
Because it says, okay, I want this house. I want this house here because it's a crop workbench, okay? When I click it, it says check purchase conditions. It says I have to buy the house, first floor, 3-1. I want it as... Don't want it as residency. As storage. Okay, I'll be back. Going AFK minute.
Okay.